In this session, we are going to see what is a ballistic galvanometer, construction, theory and working of ballistic galvanometer. First, let us see what is a ballistic galvanometer. A ballistic galvanometer is a device which is used to measure sudden flow of charges through it for a very short interval of time. A ballistic galvanometer consists a rectangular coil of wire of many turns wound on a non-metallic frame. This rectangular coil is suspended by means of this phosphorus bronze strip in between the two pole pieces north and south. The pole pieces are curved so that the magnetic field is radial and uniform at any position of the rectangular coil in between the pole pieces. The two ends of the wire in the coil are connected to two terminals T1 and T2. From one end of the wire is connected to T1 and other end of the wire is connected to T2 through this spring. Here a small mirror strip is attached to this phosphorus bronze wire. By using this small mirror, we can measure the twist produced by this rectangular coil with the help of lamp and scale arrangement. Now, let us consider a small potential difference is applied between this T1 and T2, that is, a current flows through the coil in this direction. When current flows through the coil, the sides AD and BC experiences a force, but the sides AB and DC will not experience any force because the sides AB and DC are parallel to the magnetic field, but the sides AD and BC are perpendicular to this magnetic field, so sine 90 degree is equal to 1. The forces experienced by the sides AD and BC are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. They are separated by a perpendicular distance. Let us take small l is the length of the rectangular coil and small b is breadth of the rectangular coil. Then from the Fleming's left hand rule, I can write magnitude of the force as F is equal to B I L. B is magnetic field, I is current, L is length of the coil. Now, these two forces constitute a couple. These two forces makes coil to turn or rotate inside the two pole pieces about the suspended phosphorus bronze wire. So here, moment of a force or moment of a couple, that is torque, can be written as any one of the force into perpendicular distance. So that will be F into B. Now let us put this F is BIL into B. This L into B is nothing but area of the coil. A is area of the coil. So I can write this expression as tau is equal to B I A. Now, let us take capital N be the number of turns in the coil, in the rectangular coil. Therefore, this tau can be written as B A N into I. I am multiplying N to this equation. So, I will get this equation tau is equal to B A N into I. Total impulse of the couple can be written as B A N integration 0 to T I into dt. To obtain this total impulse of the couple, I have to integrate this equation. B A N is constant, so integration from 0 to T I into dt. So this is nothing but Q, where Q is 0 to T I into dt. When coil is turning or rotating inside the pole pieces, then angular momentum of the coil can be written as I dash into omega, where I dash is moment of inertia of the coil, omega is angular velocity of the coil. So, total impulse of the coil is equal to angular momentum of the coil. So, here I can write impulse is equal to angular momentum. That is BANQ is equal to I dash into omega. Therefore, omega is equal to BANQ divided by I dash. Let us take this as equation 1. When coil is turning about the axis, then it will be having a kinetic energy. Since the coil is rotating, the kinetic energy is given by half I dash omega squared. Kinetic energy is equal to half I dash omega squared. Since the coil is rotating about the suspended wire, or it tends to turn, this kinetic energy will be converted into potential energy of the suspension wire. That is, this kinetic energy will be utilized in twisting the suspended wire. Then the potential energy stored in the wire can be given by half C theta squared, where C is couple per unit twist and theta is the first throw observed on the scale. This is by using lamp and scale arrangement, or theta is twist produced by the coil. Next, I am writing potential energy is equal to kinetic energy. Whatever the kinetic energy is there, that kinetic energy is utilized in twisting the suspended wire. So, I write kinetic energy is equal to potential energy, that is half I dash omega squared is equal to half C theta squared. Therefore, omega squared is equal to C theta squared divided by I dash. This is equation 2. From equation 1, we have this expression. Now, let us substitute this omega in equation 2. If we substitute this omega value in equation 2, then equation 2 becomes BANQ divided by I dash into BANQ divided by I dash is equal to C theta square divided by I dash. Here this I dash and this I dash, one I dash will get cancelled. Therefore, Q squared is equal to C theta squared divided by B squared, A squared, N squared into I dash. multiply and divide by C. So here I am multiplying Z and dividing by C. Time period of oscillation of a coil is given by T is equal to 2 pi into square root of I dash divided by C. If coil oscillates between the two pole pieces, then time period of oscillation is given by this expression, where I dash is moment of inertia of the coil, C is couple per unit twist. Now let us square this equation, and rearranging, I dash by C is equal to T squared divided by 2 pi the whole squared. Substitute this I dash by C in equation 2. If I substitute, then Q squared is equal to C squared divided by B squared A squared N squared into T squared divided by 2 pi the whole squared into theta squared. By taking square root on both sides, we'll get Q is equal to C by BAN T by 2 pi into theta. This is the amount of charges flowing through a ballistic galvanometer, where I can put K is equal to C by BAN, which is known as galvanometer constant. And this total term K into T by 2 pi is equal to K dash, which is known as ballistic constant or ballistic reduction factor. Therefore, the above expression can be written as Q is equal to K dash into theta. By using this equation, we can measure the amount of charges flowing through ballistic galvanometer. Thank you.